So today in this online classes, we will discuss about the calculations. So we finish the formula and now we start the, last classes we finish the pivot table. And today we start the formula, and in the formula is the first class. So we discuss about calculations.
Okay.
Right. Calculations. So first understand what are the calculations. So in the Excel, you want to calculate, say you want to sum your two numbers. We have the two way. First, we use the inbuilt formula, just like sum, right? And second, we use the mathematical operator, just like plus within two numbers to get the results. Sum is the inbuilt formula and this is the limited. In future, maybe you received any calculation, you have any calculations, and for this calculation, no have any formula in the Excel. That time, we use the mathematical operators. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So we have the use the mathematical operator in the Excel, plus, minus, divide, multiply, and power. This is the mathematical operators. You can use in the Excel directly. I give you some example how can you use these operators. Just like we have the two numbers, the quarter one and quarter two. In the quarter one have a 25 sale and quarter two have a 26 sale. So I want to calculate the growth. Okay, how many percentage will be growth in the quarter two? So in the Excel, no any formula have for the calculate this growth, but in mathematics we calculate the simple mathematics formula, the latest minus oldest divide by oldest. This is the mathematical formula. If you have a notepad and pen, you can simply calculate by divided and minus these numbers. So I want to calculate this method on Excel. So click here, latest minus oldest divide by oldest. Oldest, right? So latest minus oldest divide by oldest. If you press the enter, you will get the result wrongly. Why? Because I have not used the BODMAS method in these calculations. Do you know BODMAS method? Mr. Deep, do you know BODMAS method?
Brackets. Is with brackets?
Yeah, right, brackets. The calculation process that called BODMAS method. So we use BODMAS method, then I get the exact percentage for growth. So apply the percentage format, we receive here. So I calculate the formula. And second, next again example give you. If we have principal, rate, time. I have 50, take the loan, 50,000 for 8% rate of interest for 3 years. So I want to calculate the amount. I know for this calculation, we have the formula FB future value, but I don't trust on this formula. I want to create from mathematics. In the mathematics, we have a method, mathematics formula, P multiply by 1 plus R divided by N, then power of T multiply by N. This is the mathematical calculation, right? So I want to calculate this formula, this mathematical formula in the Excel. So how can? So I see here, we have the lot of calculations. If you calculate in the one cell directly, maybe mistake by bracket, some bracket and some calculations part. So I do the calculations from a split way, one by one. So first, R divided by N. N it means bar 12, a number of payment in the yearly calculation period in the month yearly. So 12 is the, I want to calculate the monthly basis. So 12 and equal 1 plus R divided by N. So here is the time multiply by N. So time is the 3 years, multiply by 12, convert in the month. And second, 1 plus R divided by N power of T multiply by N. Right? Then you can here T multiply by N. And in the last, P multiply by all calculation. So this 1.270237 multiply by your 50,000 amount. So I got here the hour. Total amount is the 63,511.85. Okay, mm-hmm. But I want to all calculation in the one cell. I do the calculation the split way, split to my multiple sheet and calculate. But I want to all formula merge in the one cell. This is important. In future, we have created a lot of formula, big formula, insert the one formula to another formula for the nested method. That time, you can calculate your formula to multiple, one by one, on different cells. And after getting the results, you can combine, merge and combine in the one cell. How can you combine and merge? So look here, here is the 1 plus C17. And on the C17 have a formula B13 divided by 12. So B13 divided by 12 select and copy. You do not copy the equal, right? After the equal, you can select and copy and go to C17. Delete the C17 and put the bracket and paste and close the bracket. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And also select your formula again and this is D17. Look here, D17. So delete the root 17 and put the bracket, paste the your D17 formula and close the bracket, press enter. And you could also see here your E17, select the your formula, press the control C and copy and delete the E17 and open the bracket, paste the value and close the bracket. And the last, select here, copy and go here, select here F17 and in the bracket and paste here. So finally your formula will be ready and control X to cut and move to which you really want to use this formula. It is clear, Mr. Duke?
Yeah.
Okay. Now I give you the again big example for this mathematical calculation. So we have the one cost of the product. I have manufactured the one product in the 50 rupees. Cost the 50 rupees and I want to calculate the MRP. Rules of MRP is manufacturer take the 5% of the profit of the manufacturing amount and put the add his cost and sell to distributor. Distributor add the 10% calculate the 10% of purchasing price and add the your purchasing price, sell to wholesaler. And wholesaler again calculate the 15% of the purchasing price and add to purchasing price sell to retailer, and retailer calculate the 20% of the purchasing price and add to purchasing price and sell to consumer, and consumer price is the MRP. I have calculated this calculation the 6 and 8 sales, but I want to this formula in the one sale. So formula merging method will be applied here. How can see here? This is the link with the C13. So go the C13 and double click and copy the C13 formula after the equal, and go the C13 delete, and in the bracket, remember that insert in the bracket paste here. So and also yaha also copy C24 and delete the C24, put the brackets, and between bracket you can paste the C24 formula, and also here C22, and paste here and press the enter. Then again select the copy, and D23 and paste here. Again the copy here D24, and here is the D24. So delete the 10 D24, and in the bracket you can insert here formula and select copy, and D24, delete the D24, and in the bracket paste the D24 formula. Okay, I have mistake here, the result will change, so press the undo, control Z, and copy the D24 formula and D24, delete the D24 in the bracket, paste here. Yeah, right. And copy the D23 and delete here D23 and paste the D23 formula. And again copy the E24 formula and go here E24, delete here in the bracket, paste the E24 formula, and also here delete the E24, insert the bracket, in the between or bracket paste the E24 formula, and the last copy the F23 and paste to formula F24 in the bracket. Yes, in the, or this is the, your final result. Now see here, if you try to enter the formula directly, you can get the error and mistake the multiple times, because this is a very complicated formula. But you can apply the formula to different sales, and after the getting the result, you use the this our formula merging method, copy and paste, you can get the your formula without any mistake and any complexity. Is it clear?
Mm-hmm.
But you want to command of this type of the formula incentive, you need to practice. So I give you the three examples for mathematical calculations, right? Mathematical calculations in this today class. So I request you, please, you can calculate the 5 to 6 mathematical example here and send me and analyze, and then move to another topic. Topic is logical operation in the Excel. Right, Mr. Duke?
Okay.
So first calculate and send me. And tomorrow we discuss about it. And I have also sent you the study class recording. So watch the study class recording, watch the today class recording. So and give me the your homework, and tomorrow we'll discuss about it. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Bye.